Well, good day.
Oh, no, you don't. There's one thing you can learn about me, Bryant. I don't like being hit in the face when I'm not looking. Now, this may not be a public affair, but there never was one for example. Oh, just get away from me. Do you understand? Good.
You should have finished this ages ago, Smith.
Well, if a job's worth doing properly.
How did this happen to you, Bryant?
It's an accident.
Leaky pipes.
All I know is I want to be with you, you know? Look, I don't care if it takes 6 months or a week. I'm going to be waiting for you, Doreen.
Well, what are you going to tell your mum?
Oh, I can take care of her. I'll just tell her that... Well, no, bugger, I'll tell her the truth. You know, it's our life, not hers. She can like it or lump it. I'm not going to let you down, you know?
I'm not going to marry you, Kevin.
What are you talking about?
Well, it's not that I don't love you. That's the trouble, I do. And I don't want to ruin your life.
What's brought this on?
Everything I do. Well, it's all okay for a while, but then it always goes wrong. I tried to change, but I can't.
Don't talk rubbish, Doreen.
I've got to say what I feel, Kevin. I've been listening to a lot of people, and I've been doing a lot of thinking on my own. And I know what's right. Sooner or later, I always muck it up.
Crazy.
Goodbye, Kevin.
You'll have to go to reception and sign out, Mr. Burns. Doreen, are you sure you're doing the right thing?
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't want him hanging around. What's the point?
Well, you mightn't be here very long.
Oh, I'll lose my parole. You know I will.
Well, you can't be certain of that.
He can do better for himself than me.
Well, he mightn't think that.
Well, I've done it and that's it, so there's no use going on about it. Could I work in the garden like I used to, Mrs. Jackson?
I'm sure that can be arranged. But I suggest you wait until a hearing. As I said, you could be out of here very quickly.
Oh, fat chance. I'm going to be in here for at least 6 months.
Excuse me, do you think I could see the governor, please?
I'm sorry.
No, it's got to do with Doreen Anderson.
Well, I'm afraid Mrs. Davison has already left for the day. Well, the social worker's the one you really should have a word with. Would you like me to phone through and ask if he can see you?
Yes, please.
Well, struth, is that all? You could have done a lot bloody better than that.
Oh, there's more than last time, Lee.
Well, I should think so. I told you not to get stuck into this stuff. Now, there better be a lot more next time.
Didn't know you were so keen on this do-gooder sort of stuff.
I'm not. But if I tell you to do something, you do it, right?
It's a waste of bloody time. Why should we slave our guts out for some stupid radio station? Who needs it?
You'll do as you're told.
You can't be so crash hot, Bee. Not if Judy can put one over on you.
No one puts one over on me and gets away with it. No one argues with me when I tell them to do something, not if they want to keep their head on their shoulders.
Talking big, isn't she, girls?
Hadn't you better get the toys to Mr. Reed, Bee?
I'm in no hurry.
Oh, I'm sick of this dump.
You got yourself stuck in here.
Yeah, well, I didn't know Sharon was going to be locked away all by herself all the time, did I?
She should be out soon. Anyway, you got plenty of friends.
Bee seems to think she owns the joint, but I reckon you could take her.
I am not interested in your little power game, sweetheart. Bug off and leave me alone.
But you and Sharon would make a good pair as top dogs.
Listen, you little bitch! Sharon double-crossed me. I'd like to smash her face in, and that's exactly what I'm going to do to you if you don't leave me alone.
Okay, that's enough. Nobody does any bashing around here unless I do it.
I could have handled it myself.
You are rubbing me up the wrong way, Margot. And if you don't stop it,
I'm going to come down you like a ton of bricks.
Hey, buddy, just caught me. I was about to leave.
Yeah, well, sorry to bother you, but it's important. Well, it is to me.
Yeah, well, I've got a few things I have to attend to at home, so I can't give you too much time. But, of course, I want to help you in any way I can. It's about Doreen Anderson, I take it.
Yeah, I came in to see her today. She's broken off our engagement. I can't seem to make her understand that I want to stand by her.
Oh, well, she's probably just upset. Very likely she'll change her mind later on.
Can you tell me how long she's going to get?
Well, that depends. It's not a very serious offence. Normally, it'll be a couple of weeks in jail or a heavy fine.
Normally?
Yes, but in this case, it is a little bit different. You see, Doreen has broken her parole. The magistrate may see fit to send her back to serve out her original sentence.
How long's that?
6 months.
Isn't there anything I can do to help her?
You ever been in trouble with the police?
No, never.
You have a regular job, regular wages?
Yes.
Well, then it could help if you were to speak up for Doreen. You could testify to the fact that you are engaged, that you have plans for the future. And if the magistrate sees you as a stabilizing influence on Doreen, he may be lenient with her.
All right, well, I'll do that. Thanks very much, Mr. Reed. I'll see you later.
Look, if the cops come, all you have to do is say we were somewhere else. Well, I'll back you up.
It's stupid lying to the cops, Sal. They always find out the truth sooner or later. You're worse off than ever.
Well, what are we going to do?
I just wish the hell Dad would get home. Well, it'll be them.
Well, don't answer it. Just pretend there's no one home.
It's no use, Sal. They're going to catch up with me sooner or later. I may as well face up to it now. Get it over and done with.
I'd like to have a word with a Tony Reed.
Yeah, that's me. Come in.
I have to ask a few questions about the complaint we've received regarding a case of assault and damage to property.
We don't know what you're talking about. We've been here all day.
Is that correct?
No, it's not. I didn't know what you're talking about. Sally and I had gone down to the pub just down the road to have a drink. And this guy, Bill Harris, came in with a mate. He started to have a go at us.
How do you mean, having a go?
Well, you know, slinging off at Sally. Oh, I don't know. She used to be his girlfriend and now she's mine and, well, Bill didn't like it.
I see.
Yeah, Bill and his mate had only come in to pick a fight. I know I should have ignored them, but, well, they kept on and on. And eventually I took a swing at him.
Well, there was two of them. Tony didn't have a hope. Well, it was their fault. They started it.
But it was actually you who took the first swing.
Yeah, but they were asking for it.
I'm sorry, mate, but you'll have to come down the station with me.
Will I be charged?
Afraid so. But you'll be allowed bail.
I'll come with you.
No, 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 you stay here and let Dad know what's happened.
We will need the young lady's statement.
Yeah, well, my father will be home soon. She can come down with him, right?
All right, let's go.
You pack a blood, just better get stuck into those toys tomorrow.
You're really pushing for those toys, aren't you, Bea? I thought you only wanted to get poor Reed on side so he could help you get out of isolation.
Yeah, well, that's all there was to it at first. Things have changed. If I'm top dog, then what I say goes.
But you don't really want a radio station, do you?
I couldn't give a stuff about that.
Well, it seems a bit of a waste, us earning all that money for something we couldn't care less about.
Yeah, you got a point there. What's the matter, love?
Nothing.
Oh, now, come on. What's up?
You can tell us, love. You know, we're your friends.
Of course we are. Listen, has someone done something to you?
No, it's me. I'm the one who's done it.
Done what?
I broke off my engagement with Kevin. I told him I never want to see him again, ever.
You what? You silly.
What made you do a thing like that, love?
Well, I'm no good for him, am I? He's better off without me.
Well, I think that's up to him to decide. Now, what did he say?
Well, he didn't want to break it off, but I wouldn't listen to him. It's better this way.
Like hell it is. You're obviously real keen on this bloke.
Oh, well, it's over now.
But you could have made a go of it when you get out of here. Sounds like he wanted to wait for you.
I'll probably be in and out of this place all my life. I just didn't get used to being on the outside. It's not... You don't feel safe. Not like you do in here.
No one's bloody safe in here.
Oh, I know what she means, Bea. Everything's organised for you in here. You don't have to work things out for yourself. It's only a little world.